Hey guys, it's LasithKArt here, back with another painting video, and today we're painting this beautiful lake scene near Lake's entrance. Now this one I'm going to be painting using acrylics, and I took this photo quite a while back now. I hope you guys really enjoy this video. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. Alright, so the equipment which I'll be using today are Naphthol Scarlet, Cadmium Yellow Medium, Phthalo Blue, Burnt Sienna, and of course some acrylic white as well. Now with these paints I'll be using retarder and gloss medium to help thin out my paints and slow their drying time. Now I've also got a water container handy and some paper towel. Now the brushes which I'll be using today are size 12 fan brush, size 12 filbert brush, size 4 flat headed brush, size 0 round brush, and a liner as well. And the canvas which I'll be using today, 40 by 50 centimeter canvas, only 2 centimeters thickness. Alright, let's get started. Alright, so I'm going to be starting off with a bit of acrylic white in the corners of the sky. And I'll be covering the whole sky with this first before I actually put some color down. Now just using your brush, use a crisscross motion to help blend the paint into the canvas really well, and mix in quite a bit of retarder to stop it drying before you finish the sky. Now I also like to use a bit of water on top of this to help thin down the paint even more, and also increase the drying time. Once you put your first layer of white down, just mix up a mixture of Naphthol Scarlet and a bit of blue as well. Now I also like to lighten this mixture down with a bit of cadmium yellow and also some acrylic white. Once you've got the mixture ready, just apply it, starting with the corners where it's darkest, and then working your way towards the center of the picture. Now the clouds always start darkest towards the top of the picture where it's closest to you, and as you get further and further away, they get lighter and blend in with the whites in the background. Now add a bit more white over the top of the clouds to help lighten them down and blend them into the background. and even add a tinge of blue at some spots to help bring through the colours of the sky showing through. And once I've done that, I'm going to start painting the edges of the canvas really quickly with a bit of the same mixture I had before. And just using a bit of white to thin it down as well. And I'll put the rest of it in time-lapse mode, and we'll see you on the other side. Right, so I've done most of the background already, and I'm going to be putting in a foreground tree. So for that, I'm going to be mixing a bit of acrylic white with some of the gloss medium, and thinning it down with a bit of retarder as well. And then I'm going to apply the paint to where the tree will be. So that's roughly about here, just drawing in a thin line, paint pretty thin down. So just apply the rough shapes of the tree in before I add thicker lines. Right, so once I've done that, I'm going to be going over it in a thicker paint layer. Still going to be using acrylic white, but the paint's going to not be thinned down at all. So this should give the tree that opacity and no transparency in objects in the foreground compared to the background, really. Thank you. Right, so once I've done that, I'm going to mix up a darker mixture of sort of a brownish colour. I'm going to get out the burnt sienna. This is what I'm going to be using. So I mix a little bit of that in with the white to get things going. And add a bit of red to the mix as well. Give it a bit of that crimson-y look. And I start by adding patches of colour. Like so. I'm going to mix a bit of yellow into that as well to bring out some more of the colours. Right, so I'll continue the rest in time-lapse mode. And I'll see you guys pretty soon. So that brings us to the end of this video, and I hope you guys really enjoyed it. Now the name of this painting is Still Forest Lake on a Cloudy Summer's Day. Now as always, don't forget to like and subscribe, and also don't forget to check out my Instagram at LasithKArt. And as always, please check out my other videos, and I hope to see some of you guys in my future videos. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.